This is my intro. This is my intro. What's up, my rosebuds? It's Alexa, and welcome back to my channel. So today I have a new clothing hacks video for you guys. I'll be showing you how to upcycle a men's plaid shirt three different ways. Just real quick, I just want to throw in something that's pretty ironic. So you know how I like to say flex on your ex, and I like to do these DIYs where you upcycle like your ex-boyfriend's clothes into clothes for yourself? Well, me and my boyfriend just broke up like last week, so technically these clothes are my ex's clothes. But however, he did give me permission before we broke up to let me cut up all his shirts. So I just thought that was kind of ironic and funny. So this will be the last time you guys will see this background until I get it set up in my new place, which I'm excited for because I get to do a ton of DIYs in this new place. So yeah, fun little fact. If you guys are new to this channel and like to see more DIY videos, don't forget to subscribe down below and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on the next time that I post. And with all that being said, let's jump right into these tutorials. Came alongside. For this flannel dress, you'll need your flannel, of course, a non-stretch dress for reference, scissors, and pins. The first thing you want to do is cut off the sleeves of the dress. We will be using these later. You also want to cut off the top of the flannel to square it off. Fold the body in half and match the center of the dress to the center fold of the flannel body. Cut around the dress, leaving about 1 to 1.5 inches of space for seam allowance and fit adjustments. Flip one piece so that the right sides end up kissing and pin the edges together. So normally I would pin perpendicular or diagonally to the edge of the fabric, but for this tutorial I will be pinning parallel so that I can try on the dress and make any fit adjustments from there. Once you're happy with the fit, sew a straight stitch on both sides. You want to fold over the top of the body and just pin this in place for now. Cut off the cuff of the sleeve and cut down the seam to open it up. Fold over just enough material to double it and cut a strip of folded fabric that is about 3 inches wide. Square off the ends of the piece and cut this in half to make 2 pieces. Fold each piece in half and sew a straight stitch along the edge to make your strap. The strap should be wide enough for you to invert it just by using your hand, but if you need to use your inverter, you totally can. I like to leave the ends inverted just a little bit to keep it from fraying. Place your straps wherever it is best comfortable for you and pin both ends down. Fold your dress in half and copy the placement for the other strap. Sew across the whole top edge to hem the dress and sew the straps down. Once this is done, you have finished your flannel dress. I also had a ton of fabric left over, so I made a little bow for Oliver. For this pleated skirt set, you'll need another men's shirt, a measuring tape, scissors, and pins. So I know this is a flannel, but I wanted to use this corduroy shirt because I like the thickness, but you guys can also use a flannel shirt for this tutorial as well. First, measure how long you want your skirt to be and place a pin mark on the center and on both ends. Cut across the shirt at these marks. We won't be needing the placket until later, so you could go ahead and cut this off. Next, you want to start creating your pleats for the skirt. So all I did was fold in about 1 inch or so of fabric and I pinned this down. I then repeated this process throughout the whole skirt. So I made a mistake here. You guys can see me cutting in half and then placing a skirt reference over it to sew new side seams, but I should have just left it as one big piece and adjusted the waist fit and the hip fit by taking in material for the pleats. I don't even know if that makes any sense. I know it's kind of hard to explain without showing you guys physically, but anyways, this method I'm showing you guys right now totally works, but I feel like the method that I just explained to you guys right now would work even better. So continuing on, I placed a pin halfway down the skirt on the side to mark the end of the side seam because you want to leave it open for a skirt closure. Once you sew your new side seams, adjust the pleats where you want it to fit more. I wanted my skirt to be super high-waisted and super tight at the waist, so I took in about 1 inch or more for each pleat. Make sure you adjust and take in your pleats towards the middle of the skirt because you want your pleats to be centered and not slanted in one direction. I was going to put a One Direction image right now, but my internet is down, so. Next, with your measuring tape, mark up starting from the bottom of the skirt how long you want your pleat opening to be. I wanted mine to be 6 inches, so I added a pin 6 inches up from the bottom edge. Now you want to straighten your pleats, and to do so, all you have to do is remove any pins in the middle and then pull to straighten the fold. Repin the fold and sew a straight stitch along the edge of the pleat to secure it. Cut off any excess seam allowance when you're done and fold over the top edge to hem it. So normally you would leave the bottom pleat opening undone or pressed with an iron, but since I didn't have much material to work with, I also sewed a straight stitch along the edge of the pleat to kind of fake that pleat look, or else it would just end up looking flat. Reattach the original placket to the skirt opening and re-sew the buttons where the buttonholes fall. Once that is finished, you're done because you don't need to do anything with the top. Lastly, for this two-piece set, you need another men's flannel, a skirt reference, elastic, pins, a safety pin, measuring tape, and scissors. The first thing you want to do is cut off the sleeves, and once you've done that, cut off the cuff of the sleeve. Cut off the buttons, if there are any, and add a stitch to close the sleeve slit. For the top of the sleeve, I just cut off a little bit to round it out better. Fold over the top edge to make a hem that is wide enough for the elastic to fit through, and also make sure to leave about a 2-inch gap for later. Do the same thing to the bottom of the sleeve once you've closed the sleeve slit. Cut a piece of elastic that fits around your arm and thread that through the tunnel. Like always, pin one end to the opening and add a safety pin to the other end. I'm pretty sure I do this in every single tutorial. Thread the elastic through the tunnel until it reaches the other side. Once you get both ends, add a stitch to secure both of them together. Stuff the elastic back into the tunnel and close the opening with a straight stitch. Repeat this process to the bottom of the sleeve. Next, we're going to work on the skirt, so fold your body in half and place your skirt reference at the very top of the shirt as high as the placket can go. Then cut however long you want your skirt to be and cut across the top of the shirt right under the collar. Fold the piece in half again and cut around the side of the skirt, leaving about a 1-inch gap. Place the pieces on top of each other so that the right sides are kissing and sew down the side. Fold over the top of the skirt so you make a hem wide enough for the elastic to fit through and sew down a straight stitch across to hem it. You also want to hem the bottom of the skirt using a rolled hem or just a regular folded hem. Cut a piece of elastic that fits around your waist and thread it through the top hem of the skirt. Once the elastic reaches the other side, carefully tuck that back into the tunnel and sew it down with a stitch to hold it in place. Repeat the same process to the other end of the elastic. I also added a small piece of Velcro at the very top because the first button was a little too low and I didn't want it to bust open. For the remainder of the fabric, I cut off the thick side of the placket and removed the buttons from the other side. Then I cut the largest rectangle possible out of this material. Once you've cut out your fabric, add a rolled hem or a regular hem all around the edge. Tie the rectangle piece around your body so you can see where to sew the sleeves, and once you're happy with the placement, add a small stitch at the very top of the sleeve to attach it to your body. Oh, also made a choker. It's actually just the collar thingy for the shirt, and I just moved the button so that it's tighter for the neck area, and then I just turned the collar down and I got myself a choker. I don't know if I'd wear the choker with a set. It's kind of overkill, I think. So those are all the tutorials I have for you guys for today. If you enjoyed this video, please give this video a big thumbs up to let me know that. Also, let me know which one out of these tutorials was your favorite. As always, if you guys want to connect with me, all my socials are at TheNavaRose. And I think that's it for this video. I love you guys all, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!